everyone. So today's video, I thought I would put together something really quickly about training alerts and training self-harm interruptions. So I would like to begin by saying thank you to everyone who had submitted your fan art to us. I love it so much. I hung it up. My room is not complete. I know I said I was going to do a room tour video, but that will not be happening for a bit because I have big plans coming up and I'm super, super excited and I cannot wait to get that started. So to start off my video, I want to put out a disclaimer. This is a training technique that works just for me. Some techniques that you would want to use may work better for you. Everyone has a different way of training their dog, and I believe that almost every way possible is the correct and the most useful way, because whatever works for you, and that it should be all that matters. We started our training at 8 weeks old, so remember that this will not come easy to your dog. It may or may not, but I just want to remind you that Peanut has been doing this since 8 weeks, and everyone is on their own time, so whatever you put into it, you get out of it. So let's get started.
Are you ready? Are you ready, little boy? You look ready.
Obviously, you need a motivator for your dog, and I just use his regular food while I train just to kick back on those calories and all that stuff. So I just give him his regular food. Just like a person, they need to stretch and do basic stuff before they can do the hard stuff. So I just get him to do basic commands here. To make this process go by a lot quicker, please be familiar with touch, with the nose or the paw. Here I am just getting Peanut to touch my hands with his nose. To get a dog to alert with their paws, just take a piece of a treat and tuck it into your hands. They'll try to paw at it after a while. That is the most simplest way that I can explain it. Depending on what's easiest for you or what your dog prefers, you can have them alert with their nose or their paw.
Good boy. Good boy.
After your dog is familiar with the touch, you have to incorporate hand movements similar to self-harm interactions. It's basically building skill on skill. After they know to touch you with their paw or the nose, adding the hand movements should be simple and they should catch on really quickly. Since Peanut is a medium breed, I wanted him to alert me with his snout just to make it easier at any level that he can reach me at. This next part can either go super well or actually not help at all. I would only suggest doing scent training if your dog is at a more advanced level. If you do it too early, you might just be stressing them out. So I also am fairly new to scent training. He just reached the advanced level, but all you do is you rub the cotton pad on the area or whatever you need him to alert to, him or her, and then you basically put it in a Tupperware in the freezer. Whenever they touch their nose, alert, paw, whatever they do, you give them a yes and a treat. As your dog gets more familiar with scent training, you want to introduce them to new objects to task to and to alert to. This just ensures that they are alerting to every possible thing that they need to alert to and that they don't miss any alerts. And like always, every time they paw, alert, put their snout to the object, just give them a yes and a treat and they will soon catch on. Also, there are many ways to scent train, so I will put down in the link below different ways that work for me. Honestly, in conclusion, all of these treats and all of these games that you play with your dog is really just helping them notice the different scents, and playing scent games is a game to them. But when the scent comes along, they will think, my game, it's time to play, and then they will automatically, hopefully, react to it in the way that you trained them. Every time he had a scent or smelled the scent, I would automatically give him a yes and give him a treat. And also, scent training can also be done with a mini puzzle. A dog puzzle is also a fun way to get them to interact with the scent. Okay. It gets them to interact with the scent, so put the cotton pad underneath a puzzle piece of the dog puzzle. I might insert a clip, I don't know where my dog puzzle went, but I usually used to do this with him at nighttime. So basically, all the same principles apply to each different type of training technique. For scent training, it just equals treat at the end, or playtime, or the ball, or the toy. It equals fun for them, so remember to have fun. Don't get discouraged if they don't do it right away. It does take a while, like I said, and you just gotta keep going at it. I usually do it nightly just to keep him up with the tasks and make sure that he doesn't fall behind, but honestly, it just revolves around you and how much work you put into it, you get out of it. So keep that in mind when you are training anything related, service dog related or obedience training with your dog. Remember that saying. Thank you guys for watching. I hope that this short video helped you. I'm sorry that stuff is going on in the background. It's been a crazy day. I'm filming this at 9. I had to get going. There will be fun events and fun things going on in the future, the near future. I'm so excited. So keep watch on my Instagram and YouTube for those fun events coming soon. Thanks for watching again, and we love you all.